Do different guitar picks affect your tone? Well, without stalling or waffling on for 10 minutes long, the answer is yes, they do. And they should be apparent to most people in a side-by-side comparison. So, here's your proof. Yeah, not as much of a difference as you might have expected, but the difference is there. But why does it affect the sound produced? Well, to answer this, we need some science.
Yes, science!
Okay. The note produced by an instrument can be represented as a waveform. This waveform is pretty consistent over its duration. As you can see here, the waveform is pretty uniform along its entire course, except for a short time at the very beginning of the waveform. This short period is called the transient. So what exactly is a transient? The musical pitch we're trying to play is formed pretty quickly. In relation to guitar, the characteristics of the transient are determined by your pick, fingers, fingernails, slide, teeth, violin bow, phallus, power drill, or any other item used to make the string vibrate. Through physical contact, that is. E-bows and sustainers are a slightly different story. This transient is a very short but turbulent and inconsistent part of the sound. It contains a lot of high frequencies as well as other things that don't necessarily result in a perceivable pitch. The transient is kind of like the spark you sometimes see when plugging in high power electrical items. We hear this turbulence and inconsistency as more of a noise than as a discernible frequency or musical pitch, because the transient contains much more sonic content than the actual note you're trying to play. And when our ears are faced with too many frequencies at once, everything just turns to noise. It's kind of like a bandwidth limitation. But just because it's noise, that doesn't mean that we can't identify or distinguish between different noises. In fact, we're much better at doing this than we are at distinguishing between different frequencies or different notes. This makes the transient a very important component of the sound produced. The transient is so important to a sound that without it, it can be impossible to determine the instrument or the direction in 3D space that the sound is coming from.
Who's that Pokemon?
Aside from the science aspect, not only are different guitar picks more conducive to different styles of playing, but different pick shapes, materials, and thicknesses also interact with different amounts and parts of the string. A thin pick can get in between the grooves on wound strings, making a scratchy, brushy sound with every stroke, whereas a thicker pick with a polished surface will glide over the strings more easily and with less contact, making for a less noticeable attack in general. So which pick is the right one for you? Well, I can't tell you that, but you have to ask yourself, what are you looking for in your playing? Speed, articulation, tone? You might have guessed that I like the sound and feel of Tortex picks, but I find that I can't play very fast with them due to my damned left-handedness.
A left-handed corkscrew? Oh, baby!
I can, however, play well with Jazz 3 picks, but I think that they sound like the cheap nylon picks you get free with your first guitar. As you can see, I've tried a lot of different picks, but I think that this one is a good compromise for me. It's an Ernie Ball Prodigy 2mm, and it's damned expensive for a piece of plastic. It has a shape and profile similar to a Jazz 3, but it's made from Delrin, which is similar in sound to Tortex, and wears away just as quickly. So if you're a picky eater, my advice is to try as many shapes, materials, and sizes as you can. After all, a guitar pick is the thing you're making physical contact with, and a piece of overpriced plastic or not, it should sound and feel good to use. And that last part is just as important. How does it feel when you use it? Apart from shite talking about guitar, I also like to play guitar, and these videos are a way to gather a larger audience for my guitar playing videos. So please feel free to validate both my shite talking and my guitar playing by checking out my other videos on screen now.